Hey everybody, it's Kaye here on the homestead, and I am just stepping outside for a moment. It is freezing, and it has been snowing since 8:45 this morning. I measured about a half an hour ago, and it was 5 to 6 inches, depending where I stuck my tape measure. The birds have been going wild today. It's just been so exciting. I dreamed of a snow like this growing up in Tennessee. We never had anything like this, not that I recall. I mean, we would get a scattering, lot of ice, lot of days missed from school because of icy roads with all the curvy roads out in the country. The wind is starting to pick up and blow the snow off the roof. Anyway, just take a look at some of the images from today. Oh my goodness, it is really coming down. I know this is no big deal for people who live in snow country, but boy, I've been in LA for 32 years, and this is really something. Okay, guys. Oh, that's bracing. Remember that word, bracing? Step out in that cold. It's only been snowing for like 15 minutes, and this is already kind of covered. I'm gonna have to get more wood out. I had a full cart last night, and I used half of it, so I gotta take more out. I had this all perfect for the snow today. Oh, I do not have my rubber shoes on, but I see that this is up and it should be down. Oh. Oh. I can really smell my fire. Oh, got snow on them. Snow on the camera. Okay, I gotta take this up and take a bunch of pieces out, so hang on. Okay, this happened in 1 hour. 1 hour. It started snowing about 65 minutes ago. And I just moved that 30 minutes ago, and it's already covered. I've never seen snow except like in Colorado and Utah. I've never seen snow come down like this in Tennessee, and I grew up here. They said 3 to 8 inches, and I said, oh, sure. And do I have my snowshoes that I meant to get? No, of course not. Do I have my sled? No, of course not. Let's get a handful of kindling. Okay, kindling is there. This is my fat wood. This is a beautiful box. It says Great Smoky Mountains. And this was dry season wood, but got a little snow on it, just unloading it and trying to get it in the door. So I'm leaving that by the fireplace. And I've just got it kind of cooking kind of slow in there. Just both echo fans are going. I'm thinking about just taking it easy today. Maybe baking some squash. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Let's see, how many do we have? one. It looks like there's two in there. So one, two, three, four. Oh, yeah. One, two, three, four in there. And one, two, three, four in there. That's going to be stunning because they're both happening about the same time. Wow. You want to go outside? You do? You sure? Let me show you what's outside. That happened just since you came in. They're going, what? What? What happened? What happened? Yeah, I think I'll go back inside. Yeah, your feet are gonna get so cold. I'm sorry I don't have snowshoes for all of you guys. Oh, I am just absolutely sick that I did not get my sled and my snowshoes and my cross-country skis. Yeah, you guys are really going to blend in. Now leave the birds alone. They're eating. You're going to get really cold waiting over there for those birds. So much for my lettuce and... I was going to get that in before the snow. Okay, we're going to try to see if we can get the lettuce cart inside. It's nice and warm in here. Yeah, it's nice and warm in here, isn't it? So what happened is when I first looked at my phone, I had a message from my neighbor, who is so thoughtful, they are, and he said, we're going to town. Presumably, we're going to make a quick dash over to town to... get something that they needed. Did I need anything? And I sat there and I go, I can't think of anything. I'm so prepared. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. So they went and came back and I said, oh man, I don't have a single egg. You know, I can't make pancakes. I can't make cornbread. I can't make squash bread. I can't, you know, there's so many things that require eggs. I can't make eggs. And so I said, I don't suppose you have any extra eggs. And they said, we do, you know. And he said, I'll be right up in the side-by-side, the all-terrain vehicle. And so I said, well, I can come up there in the four-wheeler. You know, it'll be good experience for me. And he said, I have a windshield. And it was snowing. The snowflakes now are tiny. And it's just like moisture almost hitting you, but earlier it was like you couldn't even see. And he said, I got a windshield and a roof. I'll be right up. And so take a look. I took a picture of them arriving and leaving. It looks like there's two people in there. Yay! Uh-oh. Don't get stuck. This is hysterical.
I can't stop on the hill.
You're running off the road. Whoa. Oh, how much fun is that? I got to get one of those. Of course, you said you had all kinds of problems with it, though. Hello. I'm Kaye.
Hey, I'm Risa.
It's nice to meet you. Thank you.
You're welcome.
That's not printed.
Whoops. He's off the driveway. Oh, dear.
Okay, there. It is kind of hard to see.
Bolt has fallen off of something. I have a feeling it's too late, but you know what? I'm trying, so let's get that door closed. Ah, I knew she was gonna do that.
Happy Jay. Okay, what do you think, guys and gals? Do you think my celery, I mean, obviously it would probably be good if I would knock all that off, but I thought if it melts in it, then it's got rainwater in there and I don't have to water it. All right, so I've got my heater on and it's just puts out a little bit of heat. I mean, I could turn it up a little. Okay, I'm turning it up on 7. That feels good. Oh, all this stuff should be outside and this stuff should be inside. Because this is, I can eat right away. Could have. All right, let's see if that chard makes it. What do you think about all the snow? Yeah, it's much more fun to play inside and be warm, right? I just don't want to leave that door open. That's the only thing. You know? Because I feel like I'm heating the outside. You know? You know what I mean?
So he had a suggestion for me about the back. You know, he's going to call somebody that he knows that used to be very good at that. Maybe he can give me some advice. You know, digging a trench in the back when the snow melts. So, oh gosh, so much happened today. I cooked a squash in the fireplace. This is my first experiment. This is going in the fireplace, and I'm going to roast that whole and see how it does. This, most of my big fire is on the left side. I'm going to put it over on this side. What happened? Okay. By the way, that got fixed. That's incredible. I have never seen snow like that in Tennessee. Ever. That's all in 2 hours.
Weren't we just here getting wood? Wow. I feel like I'm in Utah. This is crazy. Now, I don't understand this. Why is this like this before it's even opened? Is it too hot in here? Is there not enough moisture? I wanted the whole thing to be beautiful at the same time.
It's kind of squishy. I think it's done. Mm-hmm. And I haven't actually checked that out yet. But if it's good, I'm going to make some squash bread. And then I thought, you know, I'm just going to go ahead and lock the kitties in. I let them out playing in the snow when it was about 2 to 3 inches. And I thought, I'll just let the birds have the run of the place today. And I rebooted the feeder. And I mean, I set up one of my cameras. And I just shot like an hour's worth of footage. And I'm going to be uploading that just as raw video for all the bird lovers out there. You know, because so many birds came to the feeder. It was just like three were waiting. And then, pew, pew, pew. So then I thought, you know, oh, the kitties, you know, they usually sleep all afternoon anyway in there, in the garage. And so I set up, you know, kind of a structure. I never got those big window sills made. So I set up a structure under the windows with padding so that they could sit there, not only sit there, but they could also sit there comfortably, you know, on a padded, kind of insulated. It came inside the meat I ordered, the frozen meat I ordered. Spot is still there, but I thought it'd be really funny. Let's go around and walk through the snow and then look into the window and see if they come up, okay? I brought these pads over because I had them over there and I thought, oh, I'll put them on the chair here so that they won't get snow on them. Right. Look, everything is covered in snow. Okay, it is so nice. When it gets this much snow on the ground, there are no trucks and there are kind of like no cars because it is icy underneath and it's not safe. So I'm glad because I'm sure there've already been people sliding off the road today. But it is so quiet. Oh, it's wonderful. There is no water in that, but I don't think there's any point in doing that now. Look. Looky there. Looky there. Hi, baby. Hi. 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 Where's everybody? Over here. Come over here. Where's everybody? Kitties! Kitties! They're going the wrong way. Hi! Come here! Come here! Two layers of that padding and she just slid off one of them. BJ! You okay? I better go see what's going on in there. They're looking funny at the heater. I don't think there's any way that could be a problem, but I'm freezing anyway, so we'll go in. So I just came out to check on them. Everything's fine. And I noticed that the snow is almost all melted. And the chard looks fine, and so does the celery. I think while I'm out here, I'm going to do a quick inversion. And really what I want to do is I want to learn how to use that exercise machine and start working on that, because believe me, even as hard as I work, I am in no shape to go skiing. None whatsoever. The great thing about this particular inversion table is it has a massage just in this section, so it just kind of helps in the beginning, just kind of unkink. So what I like to do is I like to go level, just let all my weight sink on that massage, do that for a minute, and then go up. Relax there a minute and then ease on up. Because when you think about it, you're stretching your whole spine out and you don't want to slam it all back together again really fast. You want to kind of ease up. They love it when I'm out here, obviously. And now they can actually hang out underneath the window. Although that looks a little shape. I thought they might like that. But the top of that is a little not very strong. So I'm going to have to work on that. Spot, you're a little bit heavy for that box, baby. You need to get on the other side. The other side is nice and strong. Can you just go on over there? On that side? Good boy. Right there. That's good. That's good. Hi, Tiger.
See, I just don't think you guys need to be outside because the snow is so deep. You're just going to get soaking wet. What are you doing, Tiger? What are you doing? Good exercise. I saw the Cardinals for the first time today. I haven't seen them in a while.
Thank you so much for following my journey here on the homestead in Tennessee. I really appreciate your support. You can find ways to support my channel underneath each video. And the best thing you can do is to share it so it can grow, and hopefully I can inspire more people to take charge of their own food security and be more sustainable and live their dream and live their best life. That's what I'm trying to do here. So thank you so much, and I'll see you in the next video. Don't forget to subscribe, hit the bell for notifications, scroll down and click all so you won't miss anything right here. Ooh.
'Enjoyed this video, please watch these. And don't forget to follow me on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter. And I'll see you in the next video.